Periscopers, Dr. Olivia Joseph here. I am continuing to answer many commonly asked questions about ginger. And one reason why people start taking ginger isn't for its awesome effects on the digestive tract or for its effect on inflammation and joint pain. But a lot of people search to take ginger for male hormone enhancement. So I want to talk to you a little bit about how the male hormone system functions. So hormones are probably one of my favorite topics to talk about. The joke at my office is that I love hormonal women of all ages. I see girls in their teens with hormone imbalances, and I see patients 93 years old who come to me and ask me to help them balance their hormone system. So we're going to talk quite a bit about hormones and how the hormone system functions. But what I want you to know, males, is that if you're looking to use ginger for male hormone enhancement, to my knowledge, there's no clinical evidence, no clinical trials to prove that ginger affects the hormone system. And to be perfectly honest with you, I don't see how that can even be. Now, ginger has a lot of benefits. And one of those benefits, if you take enough of it, is not just its anti-inflammatory effect, but its effect on thinning blood. So I want to talk to you about a male hormone enhancement prescription called Viagra. So what Viagra was actually created to be was a pill for the heart. So it's a blood thinner. So it was designed to be a heart medication, and it didn't really have that effect. It had other effects. So then they didn't change the formula, they changed what they were using it for. And they were doing it, they tested it in clinical trials, and it proved to be effective. So I think some people out there, some men out there, are looking for natural solutions that aren't medication for hormone enhancement. So they start searching ginger and can it be clinically effective. You would honestly have to take a lot of ginger, a lot of turmeric, and a lot of fish oil for it to have enough of a blood thinning effect to have that effect on you. Now, that doesn't mean don't take it. Take ginger, take turmeric, take fish oil. It has effects on inflammation. It does have blood thinning effects, but to take enough of it for it to have that effect, I don't know if it's gonna happen. If you're really seeking out natural options, let me suggest a few for you. One actually is acupuncture, because what acupuncture does is it increases blood flow, but it doesn't just increase blood flow to different parts of your body, it increases blood flow to the pituitary gland on your brain. And your hypothalamus and your pituitary gland, or your HP axis, control sex hormones. So when I see patients who come to me who need help with their hormones, or their hormones are out of whack or out of balance, I'm generally doing acupuncture as part of my treatment plan, because if you're looking for natural solutions to improve hormone function and hormone balance, acupuncture is as natural as it gets. Because when you start putting things in your mouth and rubbing things on your body, there are natural options. But there is nothing as natural as doing a treatment that enhances your body's own ability to make hormones. And that is true at any age. That's true if you're a male or a female. Using acupuncture to stimulate the pituitary gland helps your body make more hormones, more sex hormones, more happy hormones and endorphins, which you've heard me talk about before. So acupuncture is one of the safest, the most natural options you have. Yes, I suggest ginger and turmeric and fish oil to my patients all the time. I just don't want you to get duped by some scams out there that suggest it's for other things, because it's not really going to change your sex hormones. I'm just being honest with you, or at least I've not seen research that shows it does that, and I've not seen it clinically after treating thousands and thousands of patients naturally using nutrition. Now, if you do have, if you concerns about male hormones, and you're a male or you're a female that has concerns about male hormones, because men have female hormones and women have male hormones, we both need both. We have them from birth to death. It has nothing to do with puberty, menopause, PMS, hysterectomy, males who've had prostate cancer, those things do affect hormone levels. I'm not saying they don't, but we have hormones from birth until death. We always have hormones because the master controller of our hormone system is our brain. Raise your hand if you have a brain. Hopefully all of you raised your hand, right? If you have a brain, you have a hormone system, and your hormones can work for you or your hormones can work against you. So I know a lot of people out there are searching for natural treatment options for low testosterone. So if you're one of those people who's searching for natural treatment options to low testosterone, stop searching for things that are gonna raise testosterone. The bottom line is what caused your testosterone levels to be low in the first place. You're just covering up symptoms unless you get to the real root cause. So I'm going to talk to you about the root cause of low testosterone in men and in women. One thing, lack of exercise. What does exercise do? Specifically, weight training exercise stimulates your body to make testosterone. So if you're looking for some magic cure and you haven't even tried exercise, you're missing the big picture. So you need to stay physically active and train your muscles and exercise in order for your body to be able to manufacture testosterone naturally on its own. Another thing is you have to know there's a hormone in your body called DHEA, not DHA. DHA is fish oil. DHEA converts to testosterone in males and in females. It also converts to estrogen. So when I see somebody who has symptoms of low testosterone, or if I have someone who has symptoms of low estrogen, one of the first things I'm looking at, their DHEA levels, because your body can't convert to estrogen and testosterone without healthy DHEA. And let's take it back another level. What influences DHEA? Cortisol. So when I see people with cortisol imbalances, low cortisol during the day, high cortisol at night, high cortisol all the time or low cortisol all the time, those cortisol imbalances use up DHEA, and without enough DHEA, you cannot make estrogen and testosterone. So my goal as a functional medicine practitioner, as a clinical nutritionist, as somebody who's board certified in Chinese medicine and also in chiropractic, I'm always looking for the root cause of the cause of the cause. And if you're concerned with low testosterone, you've really got to find out why. Because just treating low testosterone synthetically or naturally is not getting to the real root cause. So I look at causes of cortisol imbalances, which are things like stress, physical, chemical, and emotional, blood sugar imbalances, food allergies and food sensitivities, hormonal imbalances, issues within the thyroid, your detoxification system, your HP axis. So the important thing, if you wanna treat these imbalances, not only naturally, but permanently, is to really get to the root cause. So hopefully I answered some of your questions on ginger and male hormones. Yes, I recommend ginger. I recommend turmeric. I recommend fish oil. I recommend those things. I recommend exercise. That's a no-brainer. But I don't want you to get sucked into the latest scam expecting a certain solution. I want you to really understand how that whole system works. And when you really get to the root cause, naturally, your results are going to be more permanent. So I want to give you some exciting upcoming news as well. Next week, next Thursday, we are going to be hosting a live Q&A. So you can post live questions next Thursday during the Q&A section. But if you're not able to watch our scopes live, make sure you send your questions to us either on Twitter at Dr. Olivia Joseph, on Facebook if you follow me at Dr. Olivia Joseph. If you follow us at Dr. Olivia Naturals and you've purchased our product on Amazon, you can email us directly. So post your questions so that I have a list of things to go over during the live Q&A. And you can also post questions live during the Q&A. It's going to be next Thursday over lunchtime. I'm expecting between 12 and 12:15 Central Time. So I look forward to seeing you at the live Q&A, and we've got a couple more scopes coming up on ginger before we wrap up on the topic. And we also have some more condition-specific scopes coming up on things like psoriasis, eczema, and the root cause, such as food allergies, food sensitivities, and leaky gut. You're going to hear a lot more about hormones and the HP adrenal, HP thyroid axis, blood sugar imbalances, because that's primarily what I treat every single day in clinical practice. So I'm going to be sharing some of my success stories in helping my patients, so hopefully you can learn something from them. Thanks, and I hope you have a great day.